After over 4 years, this is my very first non-clamshell opening and non-military looking backpack. Do I convert to a top-loading backpack? Let's find out.
Hi, my name is Boris Mono. I'm a film editor based in Hamburg, Germany. And today I'm reviewing the Lexray Whistler Pack.
After reviewing a product, I evaluate all pros and cons to see which points might not have been mentioned in other reviews, but might be interesting to know nonetheless. This is why everything shown in this video is just a fraction of all the numbers that result in the final score. The Whistler Pack is a very cool designed backpack that is suited for an urban lifestyle and your daily commute. The Whistler Pack is a very thought out and well designed backpack. It screams high quality from the choice of materials to all its big and small features. Lexray claims ultra durable, weather resistant fabrics with military grade hardware, and I actually believe them. The material actually feels very good. The shoulder straps in particular feel very well made and extremely comfortable. The zippers are strong and smooth at the same time. There are a lot of small details like these coated D-rings or this small hidden pouch. To organize all your stuff, you have 2 pockets on the front, 2 side pockets, and these 2 main pockets where you can find 2 mesh pockets, a slot for a tablet and another slot for a 13-inch MacBook. Furthermore, there's even a secret compartment for important documents on the back, which is very well padded and has good ventilation. But all of these features come with a price of bulk. This is just a 20-liter backpack, and unfortunately it seems bigger than it should be due to all the separate compartments and materials. This is a top-loading backpack, and splitting up the main compartment into 2 parts actually makes it difficult to load bigger or clunkier items like a DSLR if there are already other things in the backpack. Further, these mesh pockets are awesome, but get in the way quite a lot. Nevertheless, you can fit a lot of stuff into this bag. But loading and unloading can be difficult due to this top-loading design. When the bag is full, do not rely on this top handle. This is a huge oversight in my opinion. A bag this well designed with such comfortable shoulder straps should not have a top handle this thin and uncomfortable. At first glance, I was highly impressed with the bag. Everything can be organized neatly in a very cool looking yet durable bag. The design and all the big and small details and the compartments are very impressive. But when I started to load the bag with gadgets and items for a 1 week trip minus the clothing which were packed in another bag, I realized how impractical this bag is for that kind of scenario. This backpack is rather designed for your daily commute to work where everything is to be unpacked at the same time once you arrive. Basically when you fill the Whistler pack with your laptop, tablet, documents and small items for work. But if you are on the go and you need to access an item quickly inside a fully loaded backpack, you might need to unpack the bag completely to get something at the bottom. But this is the case for most top-loading backpacks. Personally, I will stick with a clamshell opening backpack.
But if you want an organized and stylish looking backpack for your daily commute to work, yet you don't want to sacrifice in durability and you can live with the added bulk, then I can recommend the Whistler Pack. If you have any more questions, please comment below. And if you enjoyed this video, click the like button. And please feel free to subscribe to my channel so you won't miss next videos. Thanks.